Spam, deceptive practices, and scam policies. Know all about them so you can keep your channel safe and monetized. Welcome to Freedom Quick Tips, where we provide N95 level advice to keep your channel safe and strong against demonetization. Spam, deceptive practices, and scam policies. Try saying that 5 times really fast. Are part of the community guidelines that deal with attempts to mislead YouTube's search and recommendation systems, aka the algorithm, viewers, or frequently both. Here's what YouTube has to say about it. YouTube doesn't allow spam, scams, or other deceptive practices that take advantage of the YouTube community. Also, don't allow content where the main purpose is to trick others into leaving YouTube for another site. So, what are these policies? There is a lot to learn, so let's just dive into it. First up, video spam. Here are some examples of what YouTube considers as spammy content. Content that promises viewers they'll watch something, but instead directs them off-site to view. So, no videos that bait and switch viewers to click on a link for the actual video. Posting the same content repeatedly across one or more channels. This also includes mixing and matching clips from your own videos to create other videos, which are then presented as new videos. We've seen channels terminated. Yes. Terminated for this. Take note that this is different from compilation video that are uploaded as such with the appropriate commentary. To learn more about how to properly reuse your own content, check out our previous videos about repetitious content, link in the descriptions below. Massively uploading content that you scraped from other creators. The main difference between this and the reuse content policy is scale. Otherwise, they're pretty much the same. Trying to get viewers to install malware or directing them to sites that might compromise their privacy. This is pretty self-explanatory. Auto-generated content that computers post quickly without regard for quality or viewer experience. Promising money, products, software, or gaining perks for free if viewers install software, download an app, or perform other tasks. Different from contests in that this is a direct exchange or quid pro quo, massively posting affiliate content in dedicated accounts. This is also a matter of scale. Having a channel upload almost nothing but affiliate marketing content is not allowed. Next is misleading metadata or thumbnails, placing excessive tags in the video descriptions or tag stuffing rather than placing them as tags upon upload. Don't put random keywords in the descriptions, guys. A thumbnail with a picture of a popular celebrity that has nothing to do with the content. Thumbnails are very important metadata and should genuinely reflect the content of your video. Using the title, thumbnails, description, or tags to trick users into believing the content is something it is not, especially when there is a serious risk of egregious world harm. Misrepresenting the nature of your content through your metadata, like presenting your videos as fact when it's actually opinion, is not allowed. Manipulated media. These examples, as well as the next ones for voter suppression and candidate eligibility, are pretty specific and straightforward. Like safety warnings and products. These scenarios have happened often enough that they're used as examples. So, no excuse. Inaccurately translated video subtitles that inflame geopolitical tension, creating serious risk of egregious harm. Note that this deals specifically with subtitles. The video could be fine, but if the subtitles are wrong in the manner stated, it would violate this policy. The videos that have been technically manipulated beyond clips taken out from context to make it appear that a government official is dead. Video content that has been technically manipulated beyond clips taken out of context to fabricate events that there is a serious risk of egregious harm. Misattributing a 10-year-old video that depicts stuffing of a ballot box to a recent election. Voter suppression and suppression of census participation. Telling viewers they can vote through inaccurate methods like texting their vote to a particular number. Giving made-up voter eligibility requirements like saying that a particular election is only open to voters over 50 years old. Telling viewers an incorrect voting date. Giving incorrect instructions on how to participate in the census. Candidate eligibility. Claims that a candidate or sitting government official is not eligible to hold office based on false information about the age required to hold office in that country. Claims that a candidate or a sitting government official is not eligible to hold office based on false information about citizenship status requirements to hold office in that country. Claims that a candidate or sitting government official is ineligible for office based on false claims that they're deceased, not old enough, or otherwise do not meet eligibility requirements. Scams. This is well established, but bears repeating. Scams or videos supporting them are not allowed on YouTube. Examples are making exaggerated promises, such as claims that viewers can get rich fast or that a miracle treatment can cure chronic illnesses such as cancer. Promoting cash gifting or other pyramid schemes. Accounts dedicated to cash gifting schemes. Videos that promise you'll make $50,000 tomorrow with this plan. Incentivization spam. Videos where the purpose is to encourage viewers to subscribe. To be clear, this refers to videos with no other content but a call to action to subscribe. Sub for sub videos. Videos that offer likes for sale. A video that offers to give the channel to the 100,000th subscriber without any other context. Comments spam. Now these refers purely to your comments and not your videos. You may have a perfectly clean channel with no issues, but if you post comments similar to the following examples, you could lose your channel. Forewarned is forearmed. Comments about surveys or giveaways that promotes pyramid schemes. Pay-per-click referral links in the comments. Comments that falsely claim to offer full video content. This could be content like movies, TV shows, or concerts. Posting links to malware or phishing sites in the comments. OMG, just got tons of bucks from here. Scams.com. Comments with links to counterfeit stores. Hey guys, check out my channel, video here. When the channel or video has nothing to do with the video it was posted in. Posting the same comment repeatedly with a link to your channel. Livestream abuse. We've all been there, guys. You want to do a watch party, but not everyone has a subscription to the streaming service. What to do? Aha! You'll just livestream it from your YouTube channel. This way, everyone can watch. Genius! Yeah, no. Even if it's private or unlisted, you're likely going to get a community guideline strike with a resulting 90-day suspension from live streaming, and your stream taken down if you use your phone to stream a television show, use third-party software to live streaming songs from an album. That was a lot of ground we covered, and it wasn't even a complete list of examples. At any rate, the TLDR is: let your content speak for itself and don't try to game the system. Operate from a position of good faith, utilize best practices that you learn from other content creators, sources like YouTube Creator Academy, or Freedom. And don't try to look for loopholes to exploit, at least not if you value your channel. Let us know in the comment section below if you have any questions, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring that notification bell icon. This has been Freedom Quick Tips. See you all in the next video. Goodbye.